It's October, the creepiest time of the year, which is perfect for watching some scary movies, and then hearing a noise in your house and convincing yourself that it's all over. Well, scary movies aren't the only films that can be creepy. There are some pretty dark theories floating around about kids' movies that just might freak you out too. Here are the creepiest theories about kids' movies. If you're new to Screen Rant, please do consider hitting that subscribe button and ringing the bell to stay up to date with our videos. Kevin McAllister from Home Alone is a cute kid, except no, he's not, he's terrifying. He uses recordings to scare and threaten people, he's fascinated by his neighbor who he thinks might be a serial killer, and he sets up insane contraptions to severely injure those that he feels need to get punished. And those contraptions are pretty much always triggered by the victims themselves. So what kind of a person would a kid like Kevin grow up to be? Well, a fan theory suggests that the Home Alone movies are actually the origin story of John Kramer, also known as Jigsaw from the Saw movies and the upcoming Jigsaw movie. So what kind of things is Jigsaw into? Well, he uses recordings to scare and threaten people. Although he doesn't kill people himself, he's essentially a serial killer. And he sets up contraptions to severely injure and or kill those that he feels need to get punished. And those contraptions are pretty much always triggered by the victims themselves. One of the main storylines in the Toy Story films is that Andy is growing up and the toys have to come to terms with that. You know who hasn't aged at all in those movies? The toys. You're not gonna see a toy get older or get sick or die of old age. Unless they get incinerated or physically destroyed somehow, they're pretty much immortal. And it might be tempting to think, oh, that's nice, the toys are gonna live forever. Friendship is eternal, that's sweet. But no, I've had nightmares that were much more pleasant than the implications of this. Think about it, the toys will see the humans they love die. The mangled toys from the first movie, they're stuck like that forever. Or imagine being a toy that was left in a box in an attic and forgotten and is still alive in there. It's like being buried alive but not being able to die. And what's messed up is that another Pixar movie has hinted that this is the case. In WALL-E, which is set in a dystopian future, you can see Rex from Toy Story, probably still alive and probably very traumatized. Nemo is a cute little dude, but a theory floating around, no pun intended, makes him a lot creepier than he seems, in that he's not actually alive. This theory goes that Nemo's egg didn't actually survive the Barracuda attack in the beginning of the first movie, and that he's just a manifestation of Marlin's grief. And we kind of see Marlin go through the stages of grief. Denial, he invents Nemo's egg after the attack. Anger, he gets mad whenever Nemo wanders. Bargaining, he convinces Dory to help and then he learns to tolerate her. Acceptance, he's able to let Nemo be free. Another thing that supports this theory, Nemo is Latin for no one, meaning the title of the movie actually translates to finding no one. The Emperor's New Groove is the story of the Emperor Kuzco, who gets turned into a llama and kind of has to deal with that whole situation. Despite being a llama, Kuzco is still able to speak to people in English. And he's the only creature that's able to do that in the movie, except for this little guy. The fact that that bug can speak led fans to theorize that Kuzco wasn't the only one who got transformed. And Yzma's original plan was to turn Kuzco into a flea, which isn't far off from a fly. So it's quite possible that this little guy was actually a human trapped in a fly's body and was murdered by that spider. Creepy. Well, that's it for today's quick list. Let us know in the comment section what you think of these theories and if you know of any other creepy theories about kids' movies. If you're watching this on the Screen Rant Facebook page, you can hit that link to jump over to YouTube and subscribe. Thanks for watching.